Good morning. In this lecture series, next we will move on to next type of friction titled belt friction. And before going to belt friction, let us see first what is a belt. And let me explain you it with the help of a diagram. You would have seen a chewing machine. It consists of a small wheel which is driven by means of a larger wheel and which is run by means of a feet. And as you see here, the smaller wheel and this larger wheel are connected by means of a rope, which is in tension, and when the machine runs, the power is transmitted from the larger wheel to the smaller wheel and runs the machine because of the friction between the rope and the wheel. Hence, belt is a flexible link used to transmit power from one shaft to another by means of a pulleys due to friction between them. And once again I am repeating, belt is a flexible link used to transmit power from one shaft to another by means of pulleys due to friction between them. And now let us consider a flexible flat belt. So here consider a flat belt is passing over a fixed pulley with total angle of contact between the belt and pulley is beta radians. And now, since the direction of the impending motion is in this direction, this side of the belt will be subjected to larger pulling force or larger pulling tension, hence it is termed as TL, and this side of the belt will be subjected to smaller resisting force, hence it is termed as TS. Since the impending motion of the belt is taking place in the anticlockwise direction, the frictional force will be taking place in the clockwise direction for this contact of pulley and the belt for an angle of beta degree. So the frictional force will be acting in the opposite direction. And the contact of this pulley and the belt is taking place for an angle of beta, and in this contact area, the coefficient of friction between belt and surface be mu, and let beta be the angle of surface contact in radians. Keep this in mind, it is not in degree, the angle of surface contact is in radians, and let TL and TS be the belt tension. Since the impending motion is taking place in the anticlockwise direction, so this TL will be greater than TS. So this is TL is the tension in the tight side and TS is the tension in the slack side. Always TL will be greater than TS. And upon derivation, we can develop a relationship between this tension on the tight side and tension on a slack side by an equation. So I am here giving you the final equation alone. TL is equal to TS into e power mu beta, where TL is the tension on the tight side, TS is the tension on the slack side, mu is the coefficient of friction between the belt and the pulley between that contact surface, and beta is the angle of surface contact in radians. And from this relation, it is very clear that the tension ratio depends on the coefficient of friction and angle of contact. It is independent of the diameter of the pulley. So since in this equation there is no diameter coming, the ratio of tension is depending only on this coefficient of friction and angle of contact. It is independent of the diameter of the pulley. And next, the above equation is valid only for flat belts. The above equation is valid only for flat belts, and this beta should be expressed in radians. This beta should be expressed in radians. If the belt is wrapped around the belt n times, then the angle of contact beta is 2 pi n radians. This n is number of times the rope or belt is wrapped around the pulley. So if one revolution means, if this n will be equal to 1, beta will be 2 pi radians. If it two revolution means, this n will be 2, the angle of contact beta will be 4 pi radians. Similarly, you can write beta value for any number of turns that the belt is making over the pulley. And now let us solve one problem in belt friction. So here is the description of the problem. A 120 kg block is supported by a rope which is wrapped 1.5 times around the horizontal rod as shown in the figure. Knowing that the coefficient of friction between the rope and the rod is 0.15, determine the range of values of P for which equilibrium is maintained. And first, let us write the given data. The mass of the block is given as 120 kg, and this is the mass of the block which is to be supported in its place by means of a rope wrapping around this horizontal rod 1.5 times, and here you need to apply some load. And the coefficient of friction between the horizontal rod and the rope is given as 0.15, and number of times the rope is wrapped around the horizontal rod is 1.5 times. So 1.5 time means this is equal to angle of wrapping of the rope around the horizontal rod. And in the previous slide I have given you the formula for this angle of wrapping, which is equal to 2 pi n, and where n is the number of times the rope is wrapped around the horizontal rod. So the number of times the rope is wrapped around the horizontal rod is 1.5 times. 1.5 time means 3/2. So 2 pi into 3/2, you will be getting 3 pi radians. So this is in radians, this theta is in radians. And we know that this T1 and T2 are the tensions that will be acting on the rope. And let T1 be the tension acting on the tight side, and T2 be the tension acting on the slack side of the rope. And from the previous slide, we know the relation between this T1 and T2. So T1 by T2 is equal to e power mu theta. So where T1 is tension on the tight side of the rope, T2 is tension on the slack side of the rope, mu is coefficient of friction at the contact of rope and horizontal rod, and theta is the angle of wrapping. And now the asked question is, determine the range of values of P for which the system is maintained in equilibrium. That is, you need to find out these, what is the value of the P max and what is the value of P minimum. Between the P max and P minimum only, the system will be maintained in equilibrium. If the load is increased beyond that P max, means the system will not be in equilibrium. And if the load is decreased below that P minimum, means the system will be not in equilibrium. So they are asking you to find out the, determine the range of values of P for which the system is in equilibrium. So range from P max to P minimum. For to find out the P max, our assumption is P side of the rope is tight side and block side of the rope is slack side. So hence P should be taken as T1 and this weight should be taken as T2. So T2 is slack side, T1 is tight side, and since the maximum load is acting in this side of the rope, that is P is equal to P max, the impending motion will be towards this direction, hence the block will be moving in the upward direction. And now we need to substitute this T1 and T2 in this equation. T1 by T2 is equal to e power mu theta. So T1 is P, T2 is W, is equal to e power mu theta. So in the question, mu is given as 0.15, and we have calculated theta is equal to 3 pi radians. Theta equal to 3 pi radians. The next step, bring this W to the right hand side. So here weight is not given, instead of that mass is given. We know the formula for converting mass to weight. So formula for converting mass to weight is mass into acceleration due to gravity. So W is nothing but mass into g. So mass is 120, gravity is 9.81 into e power 0.15 into 3 pi. So we will be getting the maximum value of P up to which the block will be in equilibrium is 4839.713 newton. So this is the maximum range of P that can be applied on this left hand side, such that the system to be in equilibrium. So next, to find out the minimum range of the P up to which the system will be in equilibrium, we have to assume this P side has to be slack side. So P side has to be assumed as slack side. If P side is assumed as slack side, means the block side of the rope will be assumed as tight side. So the weight side or weight side of the block is assumed as tight side, hence it is W is equal to T1, and load side of the rope is assumed as slack side, hence P is taken as T2, vice versa to the previous assumption. And since the tight side is acting on the block side, so this 120 kg block will be moving in the downward direction and this P side of the rope will be moving in the upward direction, hence the impending motion of the block will be in downward direction. So now substitute this T1 and T2 in this equation. So now our T1 is W, T2 is load P. So T1 is W, so substitute here, T2 is P, substitute here, W by P is equal to e power mu theta, mu is given as 0.15 and theta we have calculated as 3 pi radians. And our aim is to find out this P value. So P can be written as, we know that weight is mass into gravity. So weight is 120 into 9.81 divided by this e power 0.15 into 3 pi. So we will be getting a minimum range of P as 286.34 Newton. So now this is the minimum range of P up to which the system will be maintained equilibrium, and if you are reducing the load below this means the system will not be in equilibrium. Hence the answer for our question, that is determine the range of values of P, is this is the range of value. The maximum range of P value can be up to 4839.713 Newton and minimum range of this P value can be up to 286.340 Newton. So if the P value is exceeding this maximum range means the system will not be in equilibrium, and if this P value is going below this range means the system will not be in equilibrium. So this is the range up to which a load can be obtained, load can be applied on this side such that the system to be in equilibrium.